Hi, this is Amreen, and this video is all about one of my favorite authors, Haruki Murakami. Except for the short stories, I have read most of his novels, so my top three list includes Norwegian Wood. Second is Kafka on the Shore. And the third one is The Wind-Up Bird Chronicle. Now, I don't know where to begin from or even how when it comes to describing these books. So instead, I'm going to focus on why the author matters. If you're familiar with Murakami's style of writing, then you already know why. But if you're not, then I hope this video brings you closer to the life-transforming effect his books have had on me. Murakami sublimates reality by connecting the existence of the protagonist from each of these novels into a secret passageway. You know, one that opens the door to a strange world where logic and reason play no part. Even concepts like space and time cease to exist. And whenever I find myself entering this quintessential alternate universe that the author creates so magically in his novels, you know, it somehow carries me into this dark, empty, mysterious space inside my head. You know, in real life, you can't tell the difference between what's real and what's not. But in Murakami's, in his books, the protagonist can't always see that threshold, let alone be able to understand it. Things are not what they seem. This is a very famous Haruki Murakami quote. It's from one of his books, 1Q84. And I think it's the best way to describe the bizarre narratives of the novels. Things are not what they seem. What's the fun in writing about things the readers already know about? He once said in an interview. Magical realism is the common denominator of all these novels. I mean, it's the blend of foreseen and unforeseen happenings that I, on a more personal note, enjoyed reading simply because they were recognizable, if not always relatable. And this is true for every book. For example, in Norwegian Wood, it's the simple insights into death, loss, and grief. In Kafka on the Shore, it's the journey of self-discovery where you're both fleeing from and searching for something. And to explain that better, I'd like to read one of my favorite excerpts from the book. It's really long, but it explains a lot. Okay. Sometimes from above me, sometimes from below, the forest tries to threaten me, blowing a chill breath on my neck, stinging like needles with a thousand eyes, trying anything to drive this intruder away. But I gradually get better at letting these threats pass me by. This forest is essentially a part of me, isn't it? This thought takes hold at a certain point. The journey I'm taking is inside me. Just as blood travels down veins, what I'm seeing is my inner self. And what seems threatening is just the echo of the fear in my heart. The spider's web stretched out taut over there is the spider's web inside me. The birds calling out overhead are birds I've fostered in my mind. These images spring up in my head and take root. Once again, that was from Kafka on the Shore. And in the case of the wind-up Bird Chronicle, the descent into darkness, the protagonist unintentionally takes on, I perceived as a metaphor to stop questioning why things happen in life and instead just allow myself to be carried away. I mean, it's hard to do, but it makes you wonder. So anyway, I haven't exactly talked about the plots of each book. And honestly speaking, I didn't intend on doing that either, simply because I think you can turn the book over and find that out yourself. Instead, I wanted to focus more on the mysterious tunnel the author often leads his readers into. And I feel the best part about it all is that there's no end to this tunnel. I mean, if you think you can make sense of the surrealistic theme of each of these books by the time you finish reading them, then you're in for a big surprise, because there are just too many blank spaces, obviously intentionally placed right from the beginning up till the end. Everything and everyone is interlinked. The books are a fictional maze, you know, one that the books are a fictional maze in the sense that they separate the unreal, dreamlike, or transcendental experiences from ordinary life in an artfully simple language. If you like magical realism, then reading Haruki Murakami books is a must. You can also read works by other authors like Gabriel Garcia Marquez, 100 Years of Solitude is the best one, and even Salman Rushdie, as a matter of fact. So anyway, if you would like to share your thoughts or talk more about these books, then please let me know. And if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, readadayclub, for more such book discussions and recommendations, then I hope you do that too.